Members' motion with no legislative effect. Mr. Perry Hughes will move a motion on promoting the in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism to revitalize the tourism industry. Six members will move amendments to the motion. This council will proceed to a joint debate on the motion and amendments. Later, I'll first call upon Mr. Perry Yu to speak and move the motion. Then I'll call upon Dr. Johnny Ng, Mr. Michael Luke, Mr. Steven Ho, Mr. Kenneth Fok, Dr. Simon Lee and Mr. Yim Kong to speak in sequence, but they may not move the amendment at this stage. The joint debate now begins. Members who wish to speak, please press the request to speak button. I now call upon Mr. Perry Yu to speak and move the motion. Mr. Perry Yu. President, I move that the motion as printed on the agenda be passed. The National 14th Five-Year Plan supports Hong Kong to develop itself into East meets West Center for International Cultural Exchange and International Aviation Center. Also, it supports the development of Hong Kong into a multiple destination tourism. I believe the government should formulate the development blueprint for Hong Kong's tourism industry 2.0 to promote the in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism. We have to give full play to our advantages. We have to promote the benefits of promoting different industries. President, the current term government has set up the Culture, Sports and Tourism Bureau, which is an important step forward in promoting the integration of culture, sports and tourism. Apart from coordinating different bureaus, the government should also distribute resources in an effective manner to respond to tourists' new demands and to cope with the competitive environment externally. The Bureau have to catch up with its work. I hope the debate today can provide a platform for fellow members to speak about how we can make good use of the tourism resources in Hong Kong so that we can revive the tourism industry and promote economic growth in Hong Kong with the government. We have abundant resources in the tourism industry. We have the name of Eastern Hollywood. We also have very nice coastlines and also good ecology and nature. We have the West Kowloon Cultural District, in which there are M+ Museum and the Hong Kong Palace Museum, which are new landmarks in Hong Kong. There are different new cultural facilities being completed in Hong Kong. The Kai Tak Sports Park will also be completed soon, and we will be hosting, together with the other authorities, the National Games. That is the 15th National Games. We have to make good use of the resources. We have to upgrade and add value to the industries and give full play to our advantages. In order to do that, we have to promote the integration of culture, sports and tourism. And that is the core part of my motion. I have some suggestions. On sports, we think about different major sports events. In the past weekend, there is the Harbour Swim, as well as the Hong Kong Golf Tournament and the FIA Rallycross Championship. These are all events held under the M-Mark system. How can we promote these events? We have to work closely with the tourism industry and different sectors to promote these events early and roll out products, so that tourists will come to Hong Kong because of these events and we can lengthen their stay in Hong Kong. Also, if possible, the government should avoid holding three events under the M-Mark system in the same period so that we can promote these events more effectively and achieve greater results. There are different facilities under the Culture, Sports and Tourism Bureau. The administration can think about how to add values to the facilities. Apart from serving the public, we can also give full play to these facilities. There are many nice beaches in Hong Kong, but less than 0.2% of these beaches are used for commercial purposes, and only some kiosks can be used for serving the public. The government may think about making use of these beaches for people to have afternoon tea. Also, in the Discovery Bay. We can also make good use of the beaches there, and we can make good use of the scenery there. We should create unique characteristics and provide better experience for tourists. Recently, there are people who expressed disappointment about the demolition of neon signs in Yau Ma Tei. How can we revitalize these cultural heritages? There are wetland and geology parks as well as hiking trails in Hong Kong. How can we make use of these resources and unleash their tourism potentials? How can we promote different industries and cross-sectoral developments involving financial sectors and different sectors? This will depend on the cross-departmental effort of the government. I think that we have to achieve this in various aspects. First, we have to have the mindset to develop the tourism industry. Secondly, there should be mechanism in place to coordinate tourism resources. Thirdly, in terms of promoting development of industry, there should be cross-sectoral collaboration. In order to achieve this, I have the following few suggestions. First, in terms of mentality and mindset, the government should set up a commission on strategic development for culture, sports, and tourism and invite representatives from these three sectors to formulate long-term strategies. Also, as the government formulated a development blueprint for Hong Kong's tourism industry 2.0, apart from working closely with the sector, the government should also collect views from relevant stakeholders from the three industries so that the three industries can work together to enhance the competitiveness of Hong Kong. Also, in terms of the work of the government should have cross-departmental mechanism to review the tourism resources scattered across different government departments and bureaus and discover their potentials. Also, to integrate culture, sports, and tourism, I have the following three suggestions. The government should support the industry to develop signature in-depth tourism products and continue to support the sector to discover new routes and new products to provide a more in-depth experience for tourists. Secondly, the government should set in performance indicators for different facilities. The newly set up committees will be able to play its function. That is the Mega Arts and Cultural Events Committee. I hope that the government can work more closely with the sector to achieve these KPIs. Thirdly, we have to nurture talents in the culture, sports, and tourism sectors. Talents are key. I always talk to Mr. Wong Campo. If he leads cycling tour, it will be very popular. I also joined a tram tour with a well-known director in Hong Kong, introducing the different attractions in Hong Kong. We have to promote our tourism products so that they can go global. In order to do that, the government have to strengthen training for talents and enhance cross-sectoral knowledge. Also, we should make good use of our professional services to tell good stories of Hong Kong. Through integration of different sectors and industries, we can achieve 1 plus 1 greater than 2. To promote the in-depth integration of culture, sports, and tourism, it will not only benefit members of this industry, it will also provide members of the public more options for entertainment. It will also give impetus to economic growth of Hong Kong. I hope we can all work hard together so that we can create and develop Hong Kong into a capital of events, and we can tell successful stories of Hong Kong's one country, two systems. I speak in support of the motion. Thank you.
予以通过。吴杰庄议员。 I now put the question to you that Mr. Perry Yu's motion be passed. Dr. Johnny Ng, the 14-5-year plan has laid down the 8 positions of Hong Kong, including developing Hong Kong into an East-Meets-West center for international cultural exchange. We are a cultural melting pot, and the deep in-depth integration of culture, sports, tourism is the key to sustainable development of the tourism industry. I support Mr. Perry Yu's motion of in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism to revitalize the tourism industry. The government should promote wider use of technology, such as smart tourism. Different channels should be leveraged to communicate with tourists worldwide. In 2017, the government promulgated a blueprint. Smart tourism was to be promoted. However, because of COVID-19, the blueprint was not very effective. The government should ramp up its effort by, say, leveraging on big data. Smart lampposts should be used. This can provide the data to for the tourism industry to plan the itinerary for tourists. Now, we can also leverage on smart facilities to build a cross-boundary, cross-sectoral platform. Earlier, the City Time initiative was rolled out with the use of augmented reality. The physical world is combined with the virtual world, and with AR, you can then have a 360-degree view of the city. My suggestion is to introduce metaverse ambassadors of culture, sports and tourism to promote Hong Kong. The government should also make better use of the internet, such as mobile app, so as to promote different events of arts, culture and sports to attract tourists to come. Last weekend, the Guizhou Football League came to Hong Kong for a match with the Hong Kong team. The FIA World Rally Cross Championship race was held in Central. Close to 10,000 spectators attended the football game. And on online streaming platforms, 48 billion of views were recorded. Three Asian directors were invited to produce a feature film about how Hong Kong can be attractive. Now, after viewing the different tourist attractions, I understand how the film showcases the various tourist attractions with unique characteristics in the community. And there is also a scene shot in a pub that showcases the nightscape of Hong Kong. This film will enter a film festival for viewing by international audience. I believe that there will be more eye-catching events for Hong Kong to showcase our soft power, and we can further promote tourism. The third point is that the country's tourism authority promulgated a development plan to promote a world-class Bay Area for tourists. Well, I think that we're heading in the right direction. We can also make reference to the GBA Outline Development Plan as well as the Culture and Tourism Development Plan for the Greater Bay Area to create synergy. Hong Kong is the Orient, Pearl of the Orient. Every year we record some 60 million arrivals. Tourism accounts for 4% of the GDP. It's also an important economic pillar. In this new era, the Pearl of the Orient, together with smart tourism, will help boost Hong Kong's status as an premium tourist destination. Mr. Michael Luk, the tourism industry previously relied on tourist big spendings and short stops at tourist attractions. Nowadays, things have changed. We rely more on in-depth and immersive experience of tourists. Kai Tak Sports Park will be commissioned very soon. We will also co-host with the Greater Bay Area City the 15th National Games. This will attract the eyeballs of tourists around the world. We should grasp this opportunity. I support Mr. Perry Yu's original motion on promoting the in-depth integration of culture, sports, and tourism to revitalize the tourism industry. Now, in my amendment, I'm adding to his motion. That is, we should develop activities that help promote the excellence of traditional Chinese culture overseas, enhancing visitors' sense of participation through cultural and sports programs. To give play to the advantages of one country, two systems, we are a very open city, providing visa-free arrangements for visitors. It's also a good platform for us to promote the excellence of traditional Chinese culture. We can tell good stories of our country as well as Hong Kong. Every year we have celebrations for different traditional events. This is very attractive for the overseas tourists in order to make sure that they have an immersive and in-depth experience. We should give some thought to the intangible cultural heritage and the traditional culture we have. We should help the industry develop tourism products with local characteristics, such as the Hong Kong-style milk tea and Hong Kong dim sums. Instead of just inviting them to taste for themselves, we should create the whole scene for them to have a more comprehensive experience. We should build a studio city in Hong Kong so that tourists will be able to wear the Han attire and have a more comprehensive experience. This will create some valuable memories for them. Now, through the immersive and in-depth experience, so we can help promote the tourism industry and our culture. Culture and sports is a magnet that can help attract tourists come and watch these games. The harbor swim, as well as the World Rally Race, are some of the attractions. The Victoria Harbor is our highlight. I think that we should increase our capacity so that more tourists will come to Hong Kong for the purpose of watching the games and attending these events. Promotions, coupons should be provided. Now, on organizing major events, I think the government should ramp up its effort in holding mega events. Instead of just dishing out money and holding shows, more should be done. For example, for the Harbor Race held a few days ago, it was a success, but some professional swimmers complained that the professional games started at the same time as the game for amateurs, and that affected their performance. Just next to the Legislative Council complex, the M Plus scheme subsidized the FIA World Rally Cross Championship race. It's the first time that this race was held in Hong Kong, but due to unforeseen circumstances, the track was shortened, there was a delay, and many tourists were disappointed. This also tarnished Hong Kong's image as a tourist city. So for mega events, more lead time should be put in place to make better preparations. In fact, the organizers should also be held responsible should there be any default or delays, because they cannot explain away simply by saying that there isn't sufficient time to prepare for the event. Finally, the government and the community should exercise collective wisdom so as to make Hong Kong a place of hospitality to attract more tourists. So I so submit. Mr. Steven Ho. Thank you, Deputy President. I'm very excited to learn about Mr. Perry Yu's motion and his speech. I also proposed an amendment, but I'm afraid that because of other amendments before me by other members, if their amendments are passed, My amendment will only entail the last sentence, that is to build Hong Kong into a world-class tourism destination in the Greater Bay Area. Now, in the interest of time, let me just say that at the BCPs, at the airport or the land boundary control points, visitors can get some pamphlets from a counter. The pamphlets will tell you about tourist attractions such as the Ocean Park or places for seafood such as Aberdeen. But in fact, we have other blue tourism resources such as junk trips. Say, my friends will ring me and ask where I should go squid fishing, and I'll just tell him, go to Uncle Chen. There is a lack of consolidating the resources. When visitors arrive, we should be able to tell them which base to go to. We do not have a base to support the blue tourism. These trades are so scattered that in times of economic downturn, they can't survive. It is imminent for the government to develop blue tourism. There should be infrastructural support. Land should be provided. Just small parcels of land to create landing steps. We should not only rely on mobile phones, there should be physical infrastructure to support the development. I also agree with Mr. Michael Look, there should be a studio city in Hong Kong. We should ask Chow Yun Fat to be our guide. If we just turn to the development of the Palace Museum in Beijing, you would find a paradigm shift in the demands of tourist experience. Just decades ago, I would be fortunate enough just to get in the place, and the place would be jam-packed, and I'll be happy just to take a picture. But now people will take photos. They use Palace Museum as the check-in spot, and they would just take a picture of the cat, and instantly the cat will become a celebrity on a social media platform. And they will also have a special cuisine available in the Palace Museum. Through understanding the change in the demands of tourists, we can then design our approach accordingly. Because right now we are taking tourists in coaches to To Kwa Wan for shopping, and that's it. We must take a people-oriented approach. Now, recently, the government rolled out the Night Vibes initiative to boost night economy. In fact, it's kind of tourism resources because it's a tourist attraction. Along both sides of the harbor, you have hotels. You need to lower the cost for developing tourism. Mr. Perry, you just now talked about a concert at a beach. If you allow a private organizer to run such a concert at a beach, then just by selling beer, the private organizer may be required to pay rent. But if you take into account the other benefits that will be brought to our economy, then at least you can count visitor arrivals because of the event. Because, say, if you sell fish balls at the Night Vibes Bazaar, you receive complaints from retailers nearby. In order to resolve conflicts, you should ask retailers nearby to make a joint effort to promote Hong Kong. Let's say if you want to have fish balls, you can have a bowl for just $20. And if you like them, you can then go to that shop over there. It's run by Steven HO. Finally, we have the dragon boat race. We have the fisherman culture. Despite having this race, we do not have any space for the storage of the boats.
Mr. Kenneth FOK, Deputy President, culture, tourism, and sports development have to do with national development. This is not just meeting the demands for tourists, but it's going to bring about economic growth for our country and for the city. Also, it's going to create cohesion so that we can all work towards the same target. Being the East meets West center, Hong Kong has the responsibility to promote culture, sports, and tourism. In order to achieve this, we have to leverage on market forces, and we have to be innovative to enhance the attractiveness of our sectors, and we should shape tourism with cultural activities and promote culture through tourism to display the beauty of Chinese culture to people in Hong Kong and outside Hong Kong. In his policy address, the chief executive mentioned that he is going to restructure, create Hong Kong into a new agency. We can see that it is the government's target to promote tourism industry. If we look at the funding schemes available now, well, most of these schemes run in the way that the government provides financial assistance to the industry. I understand that a lot of the funding schemes have been relaxed, but a lot of the schemes are only open to NGOs. Well, NGOs are great, but in terms of integrating tourism industries or promoting tourism industries, NGOs may not be familiar with this. In order to integrate the different sectors, I think we have to enhance the funding scheme, and we have to leverage on market forces, and we have to be result-oriented. I'm going to give you a couple examples. Well, there is a scheme to revitalize cultural heritage. It has been rolled out for some 15 years now. I understand that we have to take a balance and balance between different factors in terms of economic benefits and preservation. I have written an article about this. A lot of the community groups and organizations are tight on budget and resources. If there are too many restrictions imposed on them, or they cannot ensure commercial operation, well, not to mention promoting the tourism industry, it would be even hard for them to continue to operate. And there is another scheme promoting the development of art and cultural sectors. Again, there are a lot of restrictions to this scheme, and this is not helping the long-term development of these NGOs and the industries. Well, there is a cultural heritage scheme rolled out by the government last year, and there is a direct linkage between the cultural heritage and the subsidies provided, and this encourages the integration of cultural heritage and tourism, and there are new tourism routes rolled out by travel agencies. And there are a total of 1 million tourists from tour groups and different tours because of this scheme. So it shows that it has yielded results. The government is devoting a lot of resources to tourism industry every year. Well, we've been talking about how to use public funds more effectively. We have to promote sustainable development of the relevant sectors. I think the government should review the different schemes available now. As mentioned in my amendment, we have to encourage the collaboration of different commercial organizations and incorporate tourism elements into the activities to achieve breakthroughs. Well, if we can achieve that, then we can develop ourselves into a paradise of culture, sports, and tourism, and we can be converted into a multi-destination tourism city. President, I so submit. I speak in support of the motion, and I hope members will support my amendment as well. Dr. Simon Lee. Thank you, Deputy President. I thank Mr. Perry Yu for the motion and other members for the amendments. Tourism products is a key part of tourism industry, and it helps expand the tourism industry and stimulate consumption and spending and bring about economic growth. In recent years, all over the world, countries are placing more importance to tourism products, and the quality of these tourism products have enhanced. However, we are seeing challenges in terms of promoting tourism products. We are lacking the relevant policies, relevant market forces, as well as talents, etc. In order to better support the development of signature tourism products, I have the following recommendations. First, we have to discover local culture and traditional Chinese culture or relevant cultural products, and we have to offer more support to promoting these products. Secondly, we have to have more exchanges to support design, creation, and manufacture of different products, and we have to give more resources to this. Thirdly, we have to promote museums, for instance, and these museums will have to collaborate with the sectors to roll out more products, to open up a wider variety of products. They can be about the landscape of Hong Kong, the cultural or the traditional agricultural villages in Hong Kong. Fourth, we have to nurture or cultivate brands or design brands, and we have to support these brands to roll out characteristic products. Fifth, through consumption survey, we can promote business development in tourist attraction sites or leisure and recreation areas. We can set up stores to sell products of different brands, and we can set up platforms to promote online sales of these products, to promote e-commerce as well. Sixth, through taxation or tax concession, we should offer more support to the relevant sectors. Seventh, we have to protect intellectual property. Eighth, we should roll out training to nurture talents of relevant sectors and support research and development of relevant products and capacities of promoting these products. We should open up courses to nurture talents in the tourism industries. We have to display the results that we have achieved. Creative and cultural products is an extension of the tourism industry, and it is also helping to promote Hong Kong's icon, and it will help tell good stories of Hong Kong. So we should not look at it as a single or individual product in the market. We need the support of more industries in order to promote tourism in Hong Kong. I hope members will support my amendment. Thank you. Mr. Yim Kong, Deputy President, I thank Mr. Perry Yu for the motion. Tourism industry is a pillar industry in Hong Kong. As we see recovery of our economy, tourism industry plays a key role. Hong Kong has East-Meets-West background, and it is also an international metropolis. All these contribute to the development of tourism in Hong Kong. However, currently we are facing multiple challenges in developing our tourism. While Hong Kong has resumed normal travel with the rest of the world for some half a year now, but we are seeing a drop of 30% of tourists compared to pre-pandemic period. The government has rolled out various measures to tackle the problem. However, we are yet to see real results from these measures. We are seeing sluggish economic environment, and we are seeing less spending from tourists. We have to be innovative in order to revive our tourism industry. We have to deepen integration of culture, sports and tourism, and we have to attract more large-scale events to be held in Hong Kong. This will be able to enhance competitiveness of our tourism industry so that tourists can feel or experience the appeal of Hong Kong. In order to promote in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism, the government should set up Commission on Strategic Development for Culture, Sports and Tourism, or Smart Tourism. There should be a higher level coordinating agency to formulate strategies, and there should be strengthened coordination effort within the Bureau and across different government departments and Bureau. This way, we will be able to make use of our natural landscape and culture, as well as the events held in Hong Kong, etc. Then we'll be able to create an ecosystem for our tourism. We have to give full play to our advantages. We are an international financial sector. We have capital. We should integrate culture, sports and tourism. And through high quality integration, we'll be able to promote high value development. Take Disney as an example. It's able to develop theme parks and as well as develop films and other products. And it has some 1 trillion turnover. So we should also learn from the Broadway in New York and Moulin Rouge, and we should make good use of West Kowloon Cultural District and Hong Kong Night Vibes campaign to attract more tourists and enhance the competitiveness of our tourism industry. Deputy President, in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism is an effective way to promote economic growth in Hong Kong. I look forward to having the government working more closely with the industries to develop Hong Kong into an international tourism hub. I speak in support of Mr. Yu's motion. I hope members will support my amendments as well. Thank you.
Mr. Chan Tin Po, thank you. Deputy President. Now, in the 14th Five-Year Plan, Hong Kong is to develop into East-West Center for International Cultural Exchange. This is new thinking for the industry. Now, cultural, sports, and tourism are actually integrated. They could bring to visitors to Hong Kong. They could showcase the distinct features of Hong Kong. Mr. Perry, you moved this motion and other members moved the amendment and thank them. So this gives us the opportunity to discuss the matter. Now, after the resumption of normal travel, the mode of travel has changed. Now we are no longer just talking about some superficial sightseeing. It's more about city walk with in-depth itineraries. And this is a new trend. With this type of city walk, that we need to tap into the commercial potential, and we need to encourage the sector to think out of the box so they could develop various in-depth itineraries and tourism products. Now, we have various cultural heritage here, Candy's Opera, Taihang, Fire Boat, Dragon Race, and so on, and then we have the Wang Tai Sin Temple. So we have all sorts of cultural heritage here, and we could have city walks, say going from Wang Tai Sin and then going to Sha Tin for shopping and so on. Now, many people, when they visit Japan or Korea, they may take photos of them in kimonos and so on. So and in Hong Kong, how come this is not popular? Imagine if there are visitors coming from different parts of the world wearing changsam and doing city walks, and then they could have a deeper experience, a richer experience of Hong Kong. And then this may be an attraction for visitors. So we should make good use of our various festivals and cultural heritage areas, more publicity, and we should come up with more tourism products with distinct features. But of course, we need to properly protect all our resources. And then for cultural and tourism development, there will be more room for such development. Now, Hong Kong has always been a events capital. These mega events draw visitors from all parts of the world to Hong Kong. So I think we should try to host even more mega arts and cultural events. Now, last week we had this race that brought many tourists to Hong Kong. The WRC race, and then of course we need to be properly prepared. There must be proper arrangement. Otherwise, if something goes wrong, then spectators will be let down. And we also have the Hong Kong Cyclothon, Hong Kong Sevens, the Hong Kong Wine and Dine Festival, the Basel Art Hong Kong, etc. So we have various mega events in Hong Kong that will bring to Hong Kong overnight high value added visitors, and if they have a good experience, they will come back again. And if more visitors come to Hong Kong, of course, it will bring more business to various sectors such as hotel, catering, and so on. So we need to do more to publicize this mega events to realize their full potential. Now, in cultural arts and cultural in-depth itineraries is an important direction for Hong Kong's development. I'm sure it will help to stimulate our economy and will bring about more social and economic benefits to us. I hope all sectors will work together to promote this important development. Thank you. Secretary for Culture, Sports and Tourism. Thank you, President. Now, Mr. Perry Yu has moved this motion today. Dr. Johnny, Mr. Michael Luk, Mr. Steven Ho, Mr. Kenneth FOK, Dr. Simon Lee, and Mr. Yim Kong have moved amendments. This shows that this council takes very seriously the work of my bureau, and I thank them for that. Now, before the pandemic, the three sectors together make up 11.3% of our GDP. In this time of the government, the Culture, Tourism and Sports Bureau was formed. It is to promote, it's not just to promote tourism, but to make sure there is complementary development of the three sectors. Then there will also be proper synergy. And then within the government, we will have a team taking care of culture, sports and tourism development with the same goal, and there could be a better collaboration. And we want to use sports and culture to promote the tourism. And we want tourism to promote the development of sports and culture. We want to tell good stories about Hong Kong and China. So that's why this government has been set up various advisory committees and statutory bodies, such as the Culture Commission, Sports Commission, Tourism Strategy, and so on, to promote the integration of art, of culture, sports, and tourism. Now, if we want to do a good job, we can't just consider just one angle of a particular sector. We need to change our mindset. We need to realize the need for synergy of the three sectors. Now, since the resumption of normal travel, we have been picking up speed in tourism recovery. And in the past 6 months, visitor numbers have increased. For example, in October, every day there's on average more than 110,000 visitors. That's 62% of the level in 2017 and 2018. The pace of recovery is similar to that for neighboring countries. And then during the National Day Golden Week, on average, there were 140,000 visitors from the mainland. That's 10% more than that for the Labor Day Golden Week. And it's about 70% of the level in 2017 and 18 before COVID. So, and also with the integration of sports, culture and tourism, we're seeing a stronger momentum for the recovery of the tourism sector. Now, the 14-5-year plan supports Hong Kong's development into an East-West Center for International Cultural Exchange, the Cultural Tourism Development Plan for the Guangdong, Hong Kong, Macau, Greater Bay Area, also supports tourism development in Hong Kong. And then there's the theme of shaping tourism with cultural activities, promoting culture, food, tourism. In 2017, the development blueprint for Hong Kong's tourism industry was promulgated. It actually follows the themes of the national documents. And then Hong Kong, Guangdong and Macau are to host the 15 national games together. That will be good collaboration among the three places and exchanges at various levels. The integration of sports, culture and tourism that will help to showcase the country's soft power. The development blueprint for Hong Kong's tourism industry also proposes developing tourism products with Hong Kong characters and international characters, such as cultural, heritage, green and creative tourism. We should also strengthen our position as a MICE destination. And then could also be regional groups, cruise hub, and so on. So now, during the pandemic, we kept enhancing our tourism resources. We launched the Sai Kung Hoi Arts Festival, the Design District Hong Kong scheme, and so on. There's also enhancement of hiking trails. They are all very popular among visitors. We also launched the cultural and heritage sites local tour incentive scheme. The Mega Arts and Cultural Events Fund sponsored the Art Basel Hong Kong 2023. The LCSD organized the Pop Culture Festival. There are also various other major international exhibitions. So these are also very appealing tourism products. The Hong Kong Tourism Board, staged the Hong Kong International Dragon Boat Races in June, and in October we had the Hong Kong Cyclothon. And for the first time after 4 years, the UCI Class 1.1 road race was staged again. That's brought visitors and spectators from around the world, including the mainland. So now through integration of the sports, culture and tourism sector, we could further promote the development of these sectors, and then we could host some mega sports and cultural events in Hong Kong and bring a rich experience to visitors. This could also showcase Hong Kong and tell good stories. So and then we all could also follow the theme of shaping tourism with cultural activities and promoting culture through tourism. We will further bring mega events to Hong Kong, so Hong Kong will become the events capital, and we will also actively integrate into national development and promote the long-term development of tourism. That will help to stimulate the economy, and we'll tell good stories of Hong Kong. We'll also tie in with the national plans on tourism development, and Hong Kong could become a core demonstration zone for multi-destination tourism. I will listen very carefully to members' views, and I will speak again and give a response to members' views. Thank you. Does any other member wish to speak? Mr. Ronick Chen. Deputy President, the COVID pandemic has dealt as severe blow to tourism around the world. Hong Kong is no exception. In 2018, tourism accounted for 4.5% of GDP, and there are over 250,000 people employed. That's 6.6% of our workforce. But then by 2020, tourism only accounted for 4.4% of GDP. Now, with COVID easing, that should help the recovery of the tourism. But then habits have changed over the 3 years of the pandemic, and that's brought new challenges to the tourism sector. Well, many banking services related to tourism, for example, travel insurance, forex exchange, and so on, and credit card transactions. So that's why I hope tourism will be revived, and that will actually boost the development of other sectors as well. So I thank Mr. Perry Yu for moving this motion. Now, we need to revitalize tourism. That's important for our economic development. Now, in February, there was this major event. 500,000 tickets were given away for free that brought many visitors to Hong Kong. And then we have the Night Vibes recently. These become regular tourist spots that just brings new experience to tourists. And then there was a fireworks display on National Day that over 400,000 people watched that. And then the Hong Kong Wine and Dine Festival also brought some 140,000 visitors. So that shows that culture and tourism could be integrated. So we need to keep coming up with new ideas or mega events to keep up this trend. Now, the new policy address also proposes the need to develop tourism products with special features and characters. And so instead of the culture, and then we're going to have this characteristic local tourism incentive scheme derived from the cultural and cultural and heritage sites local tour incentive scheme. Now, we have seen various sites revitalized into hotels and for example, the married police quarters became a tycoon and so on. But then when sites are revitalized, there has to be proper day-to-day management. There needs to be software support. Otherwise, there's no, you know, these sites won't mean anything. So the people are now demanding more custom-made products. They are looking at more than just dining and shopping when they go traveling. So we need to do more to integrate sports culture and tourism, and then tourism will be a carrier for the promotion of culture and so and heritage. Now, if we have competitions brought to Hong Kong that will bring visitors here too, and then instead of just attracting people to come for games, there must also be cultural and other tourism products for them. Now, when young visitors come to Hong Kong, they are here mostly for arts and cultural events or major concerts or sports events. In the past week, so many members have referred to the Hong Kong Golf Open, the Cross Harbour Swim, and so on. All these events show that Hong Kong is an events capital. So we need to have make leverage on the various cultural, sports, and resources, and they will bring about economic benefits to Hong Kong. And we also have to keep tab of the latest consumption trends. For example, mainland visitors watch the Xiaohongshu, so we need to publicize on through that channel as well. Now, the tourism needs to keep innovating. Before we can drive the development of the tourism. So I support the motion and all the amendments. Thank you, Mr. Bill Tang. Now, on this title, that is In-Depth Integration of Culture, Sports, and Tourism to Revitalize the Tourism Industry, I think it was end of September, or rather end of August, early September, the Secretary came to Kowloon East. It's a sharing session on integration of culture, sports, and tourism. Now, I'm from the East Kowloon constituency, so of course, I know that we have good tourism development there. The East Kowloon Cultural Center will be commissioned next year. It's a cultural center, so that means it's high-end performance venue. It's an integrated art performing venue. And with sports, there is a high-tech sports park also in Kowloon East. So in Kowloon East, we will have two major venues for sports and culture, but that's not all. We have a wonderful harbourfront promenade. If you start from Kai Tak Cruise Terminal, it's a U-shaped promenade that will take people to Lei Yu Moon. But the thing is, the government and private developers must work faster to link up the entire promenade, which is about 9 to 10 kilometers, and it's also a promenade with cycling tracks. I'm sure that will bring about various tourism spots. And then there's another area of interest, Yao Tong Wan. Yao Tong Wan could most certainly become the newest international yacht club in Hong Kong. Now, there's this U-shaped shoreline in Yao Tong Wan, of course, because of reclamation. But then there are no good uses now there. Now, we've seen severe typhoons in Hong Kong. We see that Yao Tong Wan has not been much affected. So all we need is to build an embankment, and then we can link up Yao Tong Wan and the harbourfront promenade I just mentioned, and then that will become one tourism economic belt. And Yao Tong Wan probably could house some yacht some 100 feet long. Why do we pick Yao Tong Wan? Because it's close to the beautiful east coast, which is Sai Kung. So in Kowloon East, we have we do have immense potential for tourism development. And then we're going to have this environmentally friendly transit system. We don't know what it's going to call yet. In the past, we referred it to the Kai Tak monorail system. And if we're going to embark on this system again, then maybe we can bring the latest technology to Hong Kong, and it will become another tourist attraction. That is, we have this environmentally friendly rapid transit system for residents, but it will become a tourist attraction that people will just go there to take a ride on the system. For example, the mainland, they have in Chengdu, they have some sort of a cable car system that will take people from the town center to ancient town, or they have other types of transit systems as well. So for the entire harbourfront promenade, we can link it up, and then the Kai Tak transit system could also be integrated, and we add other tourism elements. Then you can imagine Kowloon East or Kai Tak will have good tourism resources and will be ready for the 2025 15th National Games. We need to make sure we stage a good game. And what does that mean? That is, after the competition, people will see, oh, East Kowloon is such a nice place. We have the Kwun Tong Promenade. FTU has suggested a standing night market there. So we can take advantage of national games, and people from the country, from all across the country, will come to see the charm of Kowloon East. Thank you.
Mr. Duncan Chiu, Deputy President, I thank Mr. Perry Yu for moving this motion on promoting the in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism to revitalize the tourism industry. In order to achieve comprehensive planning for the development of the tourism industry, we need to plan properly to bring locomotive to economic development. Now, there have been drastic changes in people's day-to-day living. People strive for work-life balance. They want more time with their families. According to the latest report, by 2030, in Western countries, 25-30% of countries of companies will be using the hybrid working mode so as to make the working hours more flexible. When you plan for a trip, in the past, we adopted the holiday-oriented approach. We based our planning on the holidays available. But now things have changed. It's event-oriented. We plan our itinerary based on where events such as concerts and ball games will be held. With changes in the traveling pattern, I think it's food for thought for Hong Kong to consider how our tourism industry should adapt to the changes so that we can also go along this event-oriented approach in planning for tourist attractions. Now, one major event is not enough. Very often, there would be synergy across different places nearby for a number of major events to be held. That means we need to regroup our tourism products so as to showcase the diversity of our city and our local characteristics. In September, I led a delegation from the tourism industry to Singapore. We attended the major INT event, but before and after this event, Singapore brought together a number of major events related to our industry, such as a financial summit and the F1 race. In 2 to 3 weeks, when the events took place, there was an influx of tourists. That's because they bunched events together. In the past, these events would take place in just 2 or 3 days. The hotel rates were exorbitant. Now they have made a change. They span the events across 2 to 3 weeks so that tourists would have more time to stay in the country and make spendings. That's like Mr. Perry, you said, we need to plan more itineraries and tourist activities. We have some really eye-catching international events. For example, we had the Art Basel and other art activities in March and April, with the participation of exhibition organizers and art galleries, as well as the M+ and Palace Museum. The arts and cultural sector from around the world would come to Hong Kong and attend these events on a regular basis, as well other events such as the Hong Kong Sevens, the INT Expo, and other events that took place, say, over this weekend. They seemed more fragmented. We need some grouping here to make sure that tourists won't be coming to Hong Kong just for a single event. Their itineraries should cover a variety of events so that we can promote our brand as the event capital of Asia. In fact, on a quarterly basis, we should organize different thematic events. Say in spring and summer, we can have arts and cultural activities, and then in autumn, sports, etc. Each theme can accommodate different major events. The important thing is to put the number of major events under the same category in the same period of time so that tourists could come and experience different events during their stay so that they have a better impression in Hong Kong. That can boost arrival figures as well as spending. We can also enhance the tourist experience. I so submit that support the motion and the amendments. Dr. Loy Kwok, I thank Mr. Perry Yu for moving the motion and 6 members for the amendments. Deputy President, tourism industry is one of the major, one of the 4 economic pillars in Hong Kong. Pre-2019, the tourism industry accounted for 3.6% of our GDP, with 6.6% of our population working for this industry. Because of COVID, the tourism industry was severely affected. Fortunately, starting from early February 2023, normal travel was resumed, and the Hong Kong government rolled out the Hello Hong Kong campaign in time. This publicity campaign targets tourists from around the world. As a result, we have seen a continuous increase in arrival figures. However, the travel patterns have changed. Many tourists don't come to Hong Kong for spending. Instead, they come to attend events such as the Hong Kong Pop Culture Festival 2023. They attended concerts. In order to find a way out for Hong Kong and tackle the new challenges, we need to mull over the points I mentioned. On the 31st of July to the 3rd of August, the panel conducted a duty visit in Hangzhou. Secretary Mr. Yang also went along our itinerary was rich. We learned about the abundant resources available for Hangzhou to host the Asian Games, in particular Dongyang City, and they yielded very good results. We should learn from them. As I exchanged my views with mainland officials, I pointed out that during the pandemic, we continued to invest in infrastructure such as the third runway system, Palace Museum, M Plus, etc. And all of these helped the revival of the tourism industry. In the current term of government, the Culture, Sports and Tourism Bureau was established. In the 2023 policy address, the chief executive spoke at length about revitalizing the tourism industry. That means the government is aware of how in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism can help enhance the capacity and quality of the tourism industry services. I think a high-level steer is required to promote collaboration across sectors so as to develop multi-destination tourism in collaboration with other GBA cities. The government should enhance overall planning. In 2017, the government promulgated the blueprint for the development of a tourism industry. A five-year plan was put in place, setting out the short, medium to long-term measures to support the development of the tourism industry. According to the chief executive in the policy address, the development blueprint for Hong Kong Tourism Industry 2.0 will be promulgated to further support tourism development. A blueprint for arts and culture and creative industries development will also be published this year. Robin's Nest, Yan Chow Tong, etc. will be developed into an ecotourism cycle with blue and green tourism elements. A holistic approach should be adopted in promoting in-depth integration of culture, sports and tourism. There should be high-level steer on the part of the government so that we become a premier MICE destination, the event capital of Asia, as well as a premium cruise hub. And that involves the effort of different organizations and departments. The Hong Kong DDC, as well as different tourism boards and other organizations across sectoral groups should be set up to tap the collective wisdom. At the same time, we should leverage on the country's support for Hong Kong, including the country's support for Hong Kong to develop itself into an East-Meets-West Center for International Cultural Exchange. Soon we will be co-hosting the 15th National Games. We should do our best to create synergy and work in collaboration with our counterparts in the Greater Bay Area to develop multi-destination tourism. I so submit Dr. Charmin Kwong, Deputy President. The tourism industry is one of the four major economic pillars in Hong Kong. It also drives the development of other sectors such as transport, retail, so on and so forth. In 2018-2019, pre-pandemic, tourism accounts for 4.5% of our GDP. It also creates about 260,000 jobs for Hong Kong. Many of these jobs are for grassroots. Now, for total spending, it reached $260 billion. However, arrival figures have not resumed its pre-pandemic level. Apart from that, there have been fundamental changes in tourist activities in Hong Kong. For example, they are spending less in shopping. They strive for other kinds of experience, such as a cultural immersive experience and going to check-in spots. I support Mr. Perry Yu's original motion. As the blueprint, development blueprint for Hong Kong's tourism industry 2.0 will be promulgated very soon, the government should devise the relevant strategies for the in-depth integration of culture, sports, and tourism. In order to achieve this objective, we should better gauge the consumer habits For example, our young people are fond of pop singers and celebrities. And through the funding mechanisms such as the mega funds and cultural events fund, we should mobilize community to organize carnivals, concerts, and other cultural activities. As winter will soon arrive, nighttime major events should also be held. There should be collaboration with the ETOs and branches of the Hong Kong TDC overseas to step up publicity and promotion so as to attract more tourists to come. I also made the suggestions to the Tourism Board. We should leverage on the KOLs, key opinion leaders in other places to help promote Hong Kong. This will yield a better result. Hong Kong was in the doldrums in the three-year pandemic. The publishing industry also bore the brunt. And this is a major channel of telling good stories of Hong Kong and the mainland. In Shenzhen, they have a very good atmosphere for readers. Last year, they also won an acclaim for being the best city of reading in the mainland. We should follow suit so that we create another growth point for the tourism industry here. We should create a zone for the creative industries in Hong Kong. We should make use of vacant industrial buildings and school premises. Concessionary rent should be provided for the publishing sector so that more cultural and creative industry activities should be held. In Shenzhen, there are seven so-called book cities, major bookstores. We should follow suit so as to attract more mainland tourists to come. Now, we need to revitalize the tourism industry so as to drive the growth of other auxiliary industries. I think that our retail industry is competing with their counterparts in our sister cities in the mainland. This is no surprise. We need to enhance our competitive edge. Now, for example, Hainan also offers a duty-free shopping experience, and in the past 12 years, they have increased the duty-free quota. Now, each visitor can get up to 100,000 renminbi duty-free quota, whereas for Hong Kong, we're lagging far behind. This will impact on our image as a shopping paradise. So we should request the central people's government to relax this duty-free ceiling to at least 100,000 renminbi on a par with Hainan. We should expedite co-location arrangements and enhance the clearance efficiency so as to make Hong Kong more attractive.
Mr. Chen Xiu-hong, Deputy President, I speak in support of the motion proposed by Mr. Perry Yu that is promoting the in-depth integration of culture, sports, and tourism to revive the tourism industry, as well as the amendments made by other members. Tourism industry is a major pillar of our economy. However, with COVID pandemic, it dealt a huge blow to our economy, and the GDP account dropped from 44.5% to 0.1%. We have some 14 million tourists in the first half of the year. However, it's still a huge difference compared to pre-pandemic level. It seems like culture, sports, and sectors haven't been fully integrated with tourism industry. We need the collaboration of different sectors. We should not only rely on the name of shopping paradise to promote our tourism. In the past, we had tour groups with dozens of people, but there are smaller tour groups now that are high-quality tour groups, and we've been talking about in-depth tourism. We should ride on this trend and create suitable tourism products so that we see integration of culture, sports, and tourism. In the policy address, it's mentioned that there should be signature tourism products, for instance, those incorporating elements of traditional Chinese culture as well as fashion trends. I think that we should make use of cultural or historical heritage to educate people on the history of Hong Kong. For instance, in Sai Kung, there is the historical relics of the Hong Kong Dongjiang Battalion. And we should educate people about the colonial history of Hong Kong. As people take part in in-depth tours, they may not spend a lot of money in Hong Kong. In the past, we had many mainland tourists spending money in Hong Kong. How can we stimulate consumption and spending of tourists now? We should roll out more immersive activities so that we can present a new experience to tourists. In October, in Central Harbour Front, there is an international event called Wine and Dine Festival. It involves wine and dine operators around the world, and it attracted a lot of people. Also, every year we see a lot of cultural and sports major events in Hong Kong. For instance, the Hong Kong Rugby Sevens, as well as the Asian Film Festival. We can learn from the Cannes Film Festival and integrate film industry and tourism industry to lengthen stay of tourists in Hong Kong. Also, I encourage groups and organizations to incorporate elements of tourism as they roll out their events and activities. Deputy President, films is not just an entertainment for people. They can display the appeal and showcase the characters of a place. A scene or a line in a film may be enough to attract people to go to a particular place. For instance, a TV drama in South Korea successfully attracted people to visit the place showcased in the TV drama. This year, in the Pop Culture Festival in Hong Kong, there were also showcases of scenes in classic films of Hong Kong. If we can further promote these films, we'll be able to attract more tourists. Recently, Hong Kong Tourism Board attracted directors to produce microfilms, and the microfilm was shot in M+ Museum and other tourist attraction sites to promote Hong Kong tourism. The microfilm will be broadcast on streaming platforms as well as in Southeast Asian countries. In the policy address, it is mentioned that the tourism strategy group will the strategy committee will replace the current tourism strategy group. I hope that the government will roll out more in-depth measures to develop the tourism industry in Hong Kong. I so submit. Thank you. Reverend Peter Kun, President, in recent years, immersive tourism has become a major trend of tourism industry development around the world. Tourists are more keen on experiencing local characters of different places, and they want to discover authentic cultures. Hong Kong has an East meets West cultural background. With such a characteristic and appeal, it can roll out new experience to tourists. In the past few years, M+ Museum and the Hong Kong Palace Museum have opened up new landscape for the local arts and cultural industry. We're trying to shape tourism with cultural activities and promote culture through tourism. And we're seeing a wider variety and more diversified tourism ecosystem. The government have been using public funds to subsidize 9 groups, including 3 music groups, 3 dance groups, and some theater groups. However, there is no coverage of opera groups. Say, Western opera emerged in the 17th century, and we are all familiar with the history and culture of Western opera. some keen fans will buy tickets to see operas in different places. Cantonese opera is listed as an intangible cultural heritage of our nation, and it is a witness of the changes of our culture over the past 100 years. We see the importance of Cantonese opera and Western opera, and they help to promote Hong Kong to be an international cultural center. For this reason, the government should review the existing measures and provide recurrent subsidies to groups of Cantonese opera, Western opera. Also, the one-off grant accounts for less and less of recurrent expenditure. From 2014 to 2015, the percentage dropped from 12% to about 10%, and the subsidy granted to the 9 major arts groups is 3 times higher than the subsidy to small and medium-sized groups or individuals, showing that small art groups or cultural groups are not getting enough subsidies. I think the government should, in accordance with the number of groups available and their sizes, provide more financial assistance. On the other hand, new emerging groups, they rely on short-term grants to operate. And in reality, they are facing a lot of challenges to sustain their operation. This shows that the government hasn't been able to effectively help these arts and cultural groups to enhance their quality and coordinating efforts. Also, between groups, there is a lack of collaboration mechanism. Since 2007, the 9 art groups I mentioned about, they have been monopolizing the market, and the situation hasn't changed till now. Another issue is that we have to solve the problem of a lack of venues. We have returned to the motherland for some 26 years now. Up till now, we are lacking of an opera theater that can house over 1,000 people. We have the cultural center, but since 1989, it has failed to compare with other major cultural facilities in the world or the ones in the Greater Bay Area. So we have to catch up. President, if we are to implement the target or achieve the target of developing ourselves into the East Meets West Center for International Cultural Exchange under the National 14th Five-Year Plan, we have a long way to go. I so submit. Thank you. I speak in support of the motion and the amendments. Ms. Connie Lam. Thank you, President. I thank Mr. Perry Yu for proposing the motion of promoting in-depth integration of culture, sports, and tourism. In Hong Kong, we have abundant water tourism resources and green tourism resources. According to government statistics, country parks account for 40% of the area in Hong Kong. We have 24 country parks in Hong Kong and 22 special areas, including geology parks and marine parks, wetland parks, etc. There are many special species in these parks. Back in 2017, according to the development blueprint of Hong Kong's tourism industry, we've been talking about promoting green tourism. However, we are seeing a single model of developing tourism industry. We're still relying on the old ways, and we don't have solid plans of developing green tourism. A lot of tourists in Hong Kong now, they don't spend so much money. They want to have more characteristics and in-depth experience in Hong Kong. With abundant green tourism resources, I suggest the government work with NGOs or different community groups to roll out docent tours and roll out accreditation scheme for those who can lead docent tours, and they can introduce ecological knowledge and natural conservation knowledge to tourists. We have good scenery and landscape. We also used to have 8 fishing villages in Aberdeen, Sai Kung, etc. And we have a very rich fishing village culture. Up till now, these fishing villages still exist and they preserve the characteristics of fishing villages. In Sai Kung, still we can see fishermen on boats and pier selling seafood products and fish. In Taipo, the whole fishing village has been preserved. AFCD in the past organized docent tours on fishermen culture as well as geology. Through these tours, students can learn more about the development of fishing industry in Hong Kong as well as how fishermen live. In Sai Kung and as well as in the northeastern waters of Hong Kong, there are also different characters. The government can make good use of their docent tours and work with the relevant sectors to design tours along the coastal line of Hong Kong so that tourists from different parts of the world can learn about the culture of fishing villages in Hong Kong. In the past, Hong Kong promoted water sports or water activities. There were plans to build water center or water sports center to hold competitions and games. And also they can be used for fishing and also surfing and other types of water sports activities so that people can be closer to water. In Sai Kung, Clearwater Bay, there are abundant ocean or marine resources, and a lot of tourists and local people are attracted to these areas for canoeing or kayaking. I suggest the government promote the development of water center in Area 77 and Cheung Kwan O. Also, the government can regularly hold a water festival in Sai Kung to enhance the appeal of Sai Kung. Also, the government can make good use of the existing water resources or water centers in Hong Kong for groups to hold tours and activities or for free admission so that members of the public can enjoy spending time on water. The Jockey Club also held a water activity or event. We can learn from the Jockey Club so that family can enjoy spending time together on the water. President, we should make good use of the marine resources we have. If we're able to do so, we can roll out more in-depth and immersive experience to tourists overseas, and we'll be able to create events capital. Thank you.
Also, Mr. Andrew Lam. Thank you, President. I thank Mr. Perry Yu for moving his motion and the other 6 members for moving their amendments. There is so much we could talk about culture, sports, and tourism. So in just a few minutes, it's not possible to cover all aspects. Now, I will perhaps just give my views using intangible cultural heritage as an example. Now, there are over 400 items on the list covering performing arts, traditional crafts, and so on. Now, for Wong Thai scene, Thai pole. We have the water, boat parade, and so on. So there are so many festivals and rituals, and so on. And then Che Kung Festival, Lo Ban Festival, the Kun Yam Festival. They are almost in every district. But I know for these festivals, they may just allow us to stage a one-day event, but then are there other support facilities? Are there products that could be derived from those? Is there proper publicity and promotion? Cantonese opera is an intangible cultural heritage. Now, it costs hundreds of thousands of dollars to set up a theater, but it's only used just for a day or two. Can we use it longer? And then there are many temples of historic value. you know, the and then there are so many stories too about Cantonese opera characters, the Three Kingdom, and so on. There are so many stories to tell, and so this is a treasure trove for promoting our intangible cultural heritage. But then there's just one, it seems that there's just one repertoire being performed or staged. And then many traditional food items have also are also on the list. For example, Hong Kong style milk tea, the pineapple bun and so on, or shrimp dumpling. Now, we can, so we can, you know, it's interesting to promote shrimp dumpling or egg tart and so on, and take Hong Kong style milk tea as an example. It's now part of our day-to-day life, and so there's actually much potential to exploit. For example, the root of tea export, and then it's also a way to promote the links among people on the Belt and Road route. And then, you know, the English brought milk tea to Hong Kong, but then we turned it into Hong Kong style milk tea using condensed milk instead. Now, I have tea jar tin that's from the 18th century. It actually has a lock that means tea was precious in those days. And then in Britain, they spent much effort in packaging tea and sold it back to their colonies. So if we just see tea as an agricultural product, we miss out on the immense potential of tea. Now, we need to promote the integration of culture, sports, and tourism. So we have to consider, say, tea as an example. It's a product, but it could become a very interesting product with such a diversity. And then it's the same with rural areas. In-depth tourism could be developed there. For example, if we have a triathlon event linking up three Hakka villages, or what about the pun chai, and that is the basin meal, then we could promote, marry that with other elements, and then that's why different members in their amendments, they have proposed various elements of sports, culture, and tourism. They could all be brought together, and then it will become what Dr. Simon Lee and Mr. Wim Kong would like to say, there is a high value-added market will be formed. Now, in ICX shouldn't just remain on the list. With the government seize upon the opportunities to marry different elements into sports, culture, and tourism, and then these ICH would be asset for promoting the development of sports, culture, and tourism. Thank you, Ms. Eunice Yong. I speak in support of Mr. Perry Yu's motion and the amendments moved by other members. Tourism is an important pillar industry for Hong Kong. It plays an important role in our economic development. Now, with the pandemic over 3 years, has changed the traveling habits of visitors. It's now brought about the emergence of in-depth tourism. So integrating sports, culture, and tourism is important for promoting high value-added tourism development. Now, after the full resumption of travel, visitor numbers on the rise steadily. It's now at the level 70% of the level pre the pandemic, and then the figures shows that also we're seeing that the recovery of tourism bringing immense benefits to Hong Kong. Now with the pandemic, visitors to Hong Kong don't just focus on dining and shopping. They all become interested in in-depth tourism. So tours that promote our culture, our food, and so on becomes very popular. My party has actually suggested to the government that we need to turn Hong Kong into vital in-depth tourism destination. For example, hiking tourism or tours that last several days that will take people to hiking trails or cycling trails or, say, country parks in Sai Kung. And then there are various sections of cycling trails in country park. We could take visitors there. People will come to enjoy the scenery, and also we could turn Hong Kong into a Hong Kong with vitality. And then Hong Kong is to develop into an East-West Center for International Cultural Exchange. So we need to step up publicity on mega events. Then the government stage various events such as Night Vibes and so on. 207,000 people visited came to this event. So that shows that community cultural promotion is important for and useful for promoting tourism. But then a night market alone may not stimulate other economic sectors, such as the retail sectors. For example, the government should consider, should also consider indoor night markets, so they won't be affected by the weather. And then there will be new experience for local residents and visitors. And the night markets could include cultural elements, say about old Hong Kong, or we can also tell people what kind of Hong Kong we want. So the government needs to give more thought to different ideas. There have to be more check-in points for local residents and visitors, so they can enjoy new experiences. And then that will help to promote the development of our economy. And then we can make use of technology tools such as AR and so on. So in indoor venues, we could present new experience. Now, I've been to Shanghai. There are many immersive experiences, say in theaters or cultural exchanges. People may develop a new script that's technology enhanced. So I hope the government will consider all the experience of other places, including the mainland. And then in Hong Kong, we need more international arts festival or concerts, music festivals. And we need to bring more prominent arts and music groups to come to Hong Kong. And then, well, of course, we have some mega sports competitions, Hong Kong Golf Open, Hong Kong tennis and so on. And then perhaps the government should also make available more venues for staging other types of sports competitions. Now, the latest policy address is announced that there will be blueprint for the development of Hong Kong's tourism industry 2.0, and we welcome that. We hope the government will draw up the plan, and then we could ensure the healthy development of sports, culture, and tourism. Thank you, Ms. Doreen Kong. I thank Mr. Perry Yu for moving the motion and the amendments. Now, like other economic activities, tourism cannot survive on its own. We have to compete with other cities. If we want to know whether our tourism is doing well, we have to refer to our market share in the global market. The 2018 figure shows that we have tourism revenue of about $3.7 billion. That's 2.5% of the global tourism trade. And then now that after the pandemic, we've only recovered 47% of the 2018 level. Hong Kong is close to Macau. Macau only has an area of 33 kilometers. It's about three Cheng Yi Island. And if we go by land mass, Hong Kong is 40 times bigger than Macau. But then Macau is narrowing the gap with us in competing as a tourism center. In 2023, in the first half, there's $32 billion of tourist spending, which is 43% of Hong Kong. And then in September, 230,000 people visited Macau. In Hong Kong, we have 2.7 billion people, and then 50% are overnight visitors. Now, Hong Kong, Macau is such a tiny place, but it's doing so well. It shows that their tourism policy is good. Well, Hong Kong is a compact city, and our costs are high. So if we rely on mass tourism, it's actually not smart. We should leverage on our unique history, cultural features, and then we should bring in mega events that will help the sustainable development of our tourism sector. Now, culture is not just about night economy or tax duty-free shops and so on. It's about, you know, time-honored traditions and so on. Now, for example, the Lingnan culture, and then we are a unique center with where the East meets West. If we could bring culture into other aspects of tourism, then that means it will be a quality city lifestyle that's approachable to many. Then we... Now, a few months ago, the government suggested developing night economy and night markets, but it seems that the government has not considered the hawker policy that needs to be adjusted to time with the development of a night economy. Mr. Perry Yu suggested that there should be cross-bureau collaboration. I fully agree. Tourism development is not just a matter for the tourism sector. There are many other sectors involved, and their support is needed. And I must also mention that when it comes to tourism development in Hong Kong, it's not just a project for the tourism sector. It is about winning the support of all sectors in the community. If a tourism strategy is not supported by the public, it won't be sustainable. If our tourism strategy could bring immense economic benefits to Hong Kong, if Hong Kong could then be part of the world stage, and then people Hong Kong could enjoy new facilities and new experience, and if our image could keep improving, then Hong Kong people will be proud, and of course we will support a tourism strategy. But if we spend money, but then the impact is not lasting, then people will not support it. Hong Kong is an international financial center. We have a geographical advantage. We also have good coastal resources, and we have a long history. So we should be appealing to visitors from around the world. 80% of the visitors are now from the mainland. Of course, we are happy that with the support of our mainland compatriots, but then at the same time, we need to do some soul searching. Why is it that our international appeal doesn't bring international visitors? I suspend the meeting till 9 a.m. tomorrow.